Curveball is hit high and deep to right field. It is gone.
Yes, yes, yes.
Travis Ishikawa hits one into right. The Giants win the pennant.
I'm stepping in the fade. There is no time to waste. I've got that lightning inside me. This is how legends are made.
Into the opposite field, Pence back at the wall, and makes the catch!
This is how legends are made.
Well, it's a high fly ball to right. Worth is back. It is out of here!
Here's one up the middle. Panic, what a play!
I've come too far to quit. Step back, I'm going in.
Popped up.
This is how legends
Sandoval
are made.
In foul territory. Giants win. A World Series win for the San Francisco Giants. For the third time in the last 5 years. And their hero, Madison Bumgarner.
This is how legends are made.
The 2014 San Francisco Giants were the ultimate team. All 25 men on the roster had a role and filled it to the best of their ability to conquer one of the greatest feats in sports, a World Series championship. This is how San Francisco won 12 games in October. To understand the success of the Giants, we have to reflect on how everyone got to San Francisco. And to do that, we have to go all the way back to October 27th, 2006. That was when the Giants hired their manager, Bruce Bochy.
Lady, I can't sleep. I'm so nervous I can't keep the beat. I can't run, I can't hide. In a damn shit can't keep us satisfied. Drifting and drifting like a ship at sea. Her love is killing me.
After 11 years with the Padres, Bochy signed a contract as the Giants' skipper to replace Felipe Alou. His first move as manager was to call up a young flamethrower on May 6, 2007, Tim Lincecum.
I got codeine in my cup, some bitch rest, I'm sipping. Groupies falling up, I'm like, bitch, you must be tripping. I'm just trying to fuck, and she just needs tuition. Why you trying to stunt? You need to play your own position. Never gave a fuck, and nothing about me changed. Still roll up them blunts, got diamonds in my chain. Yeah, you heard me, I got diamonds in my chain. And it don't make a difference if you crying in the rain.
Lincecum wasn't the only pitcher that Bochy added, as in 2008, Sergio Romo was called up to the majors on June 24th to be a formidable force in the bullpen. Pablo Sandoval was the next piece of the puzzle after he spent 5 years in the minors before being called up on August 13th, 2008.
Dímelo, parcero. Siempre con la seta y no somos salsero. Ya usan soltero. Dijo que de bala va a haber aguacero. Gusanos como tú, yo no los tolero. Cabrón, tú eres chota, tú eres reportero.
Sandoval was actually signed at the age of 16 on May 8, 2003, after he was discovered as a young prospect from the Dominican Republic as a catcher, but transitioned to third base after he got called up to the majors. During the 2008 regular season, Tim Lincecum started to show the first sign of success for the young squad as he won the 2008 Cy Young Award. Jeremy Affeldt joined the team on November 17, 2008 as a bullpen arm after a season with the Cincinnati Reds. You can't buy me. Affeldt credited his decision to sign in San Francisco in large part due to his admiration for the starting pitching, featuring Tim Lincecum, Matt Cain, Barry Zito, and Randy Johnson for 8 combined Cy Youngs, stating, "With that starting rotation, the bullpen won't get burnt out." The next addition was to add force behind the dish on September 2, 2009, as San Francisco called up Buster. Less than a week later, on September 8th, Madison Bumgarner made his major league debut.
And that's why they call me.
At season's end, Tim Lincecum shined on the mound once again, winning the 2009 Cy Young. Headed into the 2010 season, the Giants' bullpen continued to take shape as Santiago Casilla crossed the bay from Oakland and joined San Francisco in the offseason. And the bullpen once more added another arm at the trade deadline in the form of Javier Lopez.
I feel so divine, giving thanks I'm alive, cause we came a long way since our days in the A. Sleepless nights, was trying to get right, now I just glide, wind in my sails. I toast to the ocean, she balanced my scales. West coasting, got the breeze in my left, believe in me black, when life do you ask, stay focused, true indeed it's a fact, when them hard times come, love will bring you right back.
Buster Posey proved his productivity in his first year as he won Rookie of the Year at season's end, but the bigger accomplishment was team-wide as the San Francisco Giants won the 2010 World Series.
Here it is, struck him out, and for the first time since 1954, the Giants are world champions.
In the offseason, the Giants took a risk on an arm that was thought to be washed up in Ryan Vogelsong. Vogelsong was brought on as a reliever, but was almost immediately transitioned into a starter and made his first start since 2004 to become a regular starter in the Giants' rotation. In the spring of 2011, two new Brandons were welcomed into the fold, the first of which was Brandon Belt, who was called up on March 30th. The second Brandon was called up a month later in the form of shortstop Brandon Crawford.
When the lights turn down, they don't know what they heard. Strike the march, play it loud, giving love to the world. We'll be raising our hands, shining up to the sky. Cause we got the fire, fire, fire. Yeah, we got the fire, fire, fire. And we're gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We're gonna let it burn, 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 burn. Gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We're gonna let it burn, 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 burn.
After the 2011 season, Gregor Blanco was signed in a bench role for the outfield. The Giants added another signee in the 2012 offseason as Yusmeiro Petit traveled down the West Coast from Seattle to San Francisco. During the 2012 season, another outfield bench piece was added in Juan Perez, who was called up in June.
You can take a swing at my ego. You can make a run for my crown. Even with an army of people, you ain't gonna take us down. You can aim your evil right at us. You can drop your bombs on the ground. Even if you stare makes me nervous, you ain't gonna take us down.
July 2012 was a big month for San Francisco. Buster Posey was named to an all-star team, and the G-Men made a move at the trade deadline, acquiring Hunter Pence from the Phillies, who instantly became a leader in the outfield and the clubhouse.
Let's get ready to rumble! Feel the fires into the rear! It's nice and only know how to win!
The arms kept coming to the majors for San Francisco, with Gene Machi called up on September 1st.
Yo, Diego Calderón, Omar, los bandoleros.
Aunque digan que soy un bandolero donde me voy, le doy gracias a Dios por hoy estar donde estoy. Y voy a seguir con mi tumba.
The All-Star Game wasn't the only accolade that Buster Posey would win in 2012. He was named Comeback Player of the Year, the National League Batting Champion, and the NL MVP. The 2012 success for the Giants wouldn't stop there, as they would go on to roll through the postseason and win the 2012 World Series, with Pablo Sandoval securing the series MVP after a 3-home-run performance in Game 1 against the Detroit Tigers.
Wasn't activated until the third week of August. Into center, at the wall. Another Pablo Sandoval with a 3-homer game in World Series game number 1. Again, the 2-2 pitch. Got him looking, and the Giants have won it all.
There were no notables added in the offseason after the World Series victory, but it didn't matter, as the Giants had 3 All-Stars in Sergio Romo, Madison Bumgarner, and Buster Posey in the 2013 season. but the Giants couldn't repeat their 2012 success and miss the playoffs. In the offseason, San Francisco added a big veteran arm, signing 38-year-old Tim Hudson from Atlanta on November 18th. A big bat came right behind the big arm, with Michael Morse coming to San Fran on a one-year deal. Leading into the 2014 season, Bumgarner came into the year as the ace for the Giants for the very first time, and he lived up to the billing, earning NL Pitcher of the Month in May as he started the season 8-3 on the Hill, boasting a 2.68 ERA. Sergio Romo was the Giants' closer to start the season, and through May 9th, he had a 1.65 ERA and 12 saves. But that day boasted bad news for the Giants, as he then struggled, recording 5 blown saves and a 9.0 ERA from May 9th to June 30th. On that day, Bochy announced that the Giants were going to switch to closer by committee, which saw Santiago Casilla seeing an increased role. May 9th also saw Brandon Belt get hit on the hand by a pitch, breaking his thumb and not returning until September 15th from the injury. Early in the year as well, Marco Scudero suffered a career-ending back injury, leaving a hole at second base, which was almost immediately filled by rookie Joe Panic, who made his major league debut on June 21st, 2014.
Don't panic. Nigga, don't panic. Don't panic. Nigga, don't panic. Shorty fell in love with a hustle. Man, I took her from a bus. Niggas keep talking like they know something. I slide on your bitch like she owes something. Don't panic. Don't panic. We're just getting started, nigga. Don't panic.
A few days later, Tim Lincecum threw a no-hitter versus the Padres on June 25th.
And Lincecum has done it again. He has no-hit the San Diego Padres for the second time in 2 years.
But it wasn't all roses for the Giants' arms, as Matt Cain struggled with elbow injuries that held him out for the rest of the year. The Giants also lost 6 straight at the end of July, so a change needed to be made and a starter needed to be added, so the Giants acquired Jake Peavy from Boston at the trade deadline. That wasn't enough change for San Francisco, as they also called up outfielder Travis Ishikawa. Orange and Black also added some bench depth in the form of Matt Duffy a day later.
Who's the boss? Dudes is lost. Don't think cause I'm iced out, I'ma cool off. Who else but me? And if you don't feel me, that means you can't touch me. It's ugly, trust me. Get it right, dog. We ain't never left. We just move in silence and rep to the death. It's official. I survived what I've been through. Y'all got drama, the saga continues.
We ain't going nowhere. We ain't going nowhere. We can't be stopped now, cause it's bad boy for life. We ain't going nowhere. We ain't going nowhere. We can't be stopped now, cause it's bad boy for life.
Down the stretch, the Giants started to put everything together as Yusmeiro Petit found himself a little bit of MLB history on August 28th as he retired his 46th consecutive batter, passing Mark Burley for the MLB record. There was one final piece to be added in order to complete the 2014 Giants roster, and that was helping out the closing pitching some more by calling up Hunter Strickland to make his MLB debut on September 1st, 2014. Then down the stretch, the injury bug would start to hit San Francisco. Michael Moore suffered a strained oblique that would hold him out for the rest of the regular season, as well as the start of the postseason, and the injuries weren't over there. Angel Pagan underwent season-ending back surgery on September 25th, 2014, forcing a bigger role for Blanco, Perez, and Ichikawa in the outfield. But it was a bittersweet day on the 25th of September, as San Francisco would also clinch a playoff berth on that day. After the losing streak in July, the Giants had found themselves 2.5 games out of the division lead and out of the wildcard spot. But a monumental collapse by Milwaukee, finishing the year 31-48, allowed for the Giants to easily secure the second wildcard spot after they finished the season with an 88-74 record tied with the Pittsburgh Pirates. But the wildcard game had to be played in Pittsburgh due to the Pirates winning the season series versus San Francisco. After game 162, Hunter Pence addressed the fans to thank them and hype them up for the postseason.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Pence also hyped up his team after the game as well.
Bochy said it a long time ago when we had that meeting. He said, we got the motherfucking champion blood. We got the motherfucking champion blood. We got the
In the wild card game, Madison Bumgarner got the start against Edison Volquez of the Pirates. The score was tied at zero headed into the fourth, but singles by Sandoval and Pence, as well as a walk by Belt, left the bases loaded and no outs for Brandon Crawford.
And the curveball is hit high and deep to right field. It is gone! Brandon Crawford silences the crowd here in Pittsburgh with a grand slam.
Then in the sixth, a Brandon Belt single drove in Pence. And the next inning, Belt did it again, singling, driving in both Panic and Posey. And in case the game was even in question, Buster Posey drove in Gregor Blanco in the eighth to give the Giants an 8-0 lead. Those eight runs and help from the defense.
Jammed him and he gets a pop-up. In foul territory, a play for Sandoval and he makes the catch and sticks the landing.
Was more than enough for Bumgarner, who went the distance, only allowing four hits in a complete game shutout to lead the Giants to the NLDS versus the Washington Nationals.
And this should do it. Buster Posey puts the squeeze on it, and the San Francisco Giants have defeated the Pittsburgh Pirates and advanced on to the National League Division Series, where they will begin a best of five with the Washington Nationals on Friday.
With the ace Bumgarner having gone the distance 2 days earlier, the Giants moved on to their newly acquired arm Jake Peavy in the first game of the NLDS versus Steven Strasburg in Washington. With the game tied at zero, Joe Panic singled home Travis Ishikawa in the third.
On a hop pass, Cabrera on into right center field. Here's Ishikawa, Peavy to third. It's 1-0 Giants.
And in the fourth, Brandon Belt drove in Hunter Pence.
Here in the fourth. And a base hit to right. Do they try it with Pence? Tim Flannery waving him home. Throw to the plate will be too late. 2-0 San Francisco.
Peavy pitched nearly flawless baseball for the first five innings, but ran into some trouble in the sixth, giving up a double to Nate Sherholtz, and was pulled after giving up a two-out walk to Jason Wirth. Javier Lopez came in to try to stop the bleeding, but he gave up a walk to Adam LaRoche to load the bases.
The 3-1. Ball four, the bases are loaded.
Bochy put faith in his newest bullpen arm, handing Hunter Strickland the ball in only his 10th ever Major League appearance. And he delivered, striking out Ian Desmond to get out of the inning.
And the Giants' closer of the future shuts down an inning in the present. The Nationals leave the bases loaded.
The seventh started out with a leadoff triple from Panic.
His home plate and lowers his arm angle.
Joe Panic with a drive well struck out to center field. Span on the move at the track at the wall. He can't make the catch. Panic running hard all the way out of the box into third easily with a leadoff triple.
And an RBI single by Posey to drive him in.
Back up the middle, past Stammen and trickling into shallow center field to make it 3-0 Giants.
The Giants held a 3-0 lead, headed into the bottom of the seventh, with Strickland still on the mound. But he would get rocked twice in the inning, allowing homers to Bryce Harper and Asdrubal Cabrera.
That ball is absolutely crushed! Santa Maria!
Well, the possibilities there are really intriguing.
Cabrera with a drive! And that one's gone!
Affelt came in to stop the bleeding in the seventh. Sergio Romo would get the hold in the eighth, and Santiago Casilla retired the side to record the save in the ninth, as the Giants took game one by a score of 3-2.
On the first pitch, a bouncer for Joe Panic, and the Giants have stolen game one on the road, a 3-2 win in D.C.
Game two was a pitcher's duel from the opening pitch. Tim Hudson started on the rubber for Sam Fran and pitched 7 1/3 innings of one-run baseball, but was outmatched by Jordan Zimmerman for Washington, who came one out shy of a complete game shutout before walking Joe Panic. Nationals manager Matt Williams made the decision to bring on his closer, Drew Storen, who couldn't finish the job. A single by Posey.
On the first pitch, that's into shallow left center, a base hit.
And an RBI double by Sandoval sent the game into extras.
Sandoval into the opposite field, that's a fair ball! Panic scores, and this game is tied! They're going to try it with Posey, the throw to the plate!
The play also made history as Posey was thrown out at the plate, and Bruce Bochy called for the first ever postseason replay review. But the call stood, and the game went to extras.
And they got him.
And the call is confirmed.
Neither team could get anything going with their bats. The closest either team got to scoring was the Giants stranding Hunter Pence on third with one out, and in the same inning, Yusmeiro Petit coming in to pitch. He would record 6 straight innings of shutout baseball headed into the 18th. Brandon Belt led off that inning, and after 6 hours, finally broke the 1-1 tie.
Belt with a drive hammered to deep right field, and that one is gone!
Bochy brought out his last reliever from the pen in Hunter Strickland for a save opportunity, and he did just that, retiring the Nationals for his second ever Major League save and giving the Giants a 2-0 series lead.
The 2-2 pitch. Worth sends a ball out to right center. And that is that. Hunter Pence is there to make the catch, and this series goes back to San Francisco with the Giants in command. A one-run win in the opener, a come-from-behind one-run 18-inning win tonight in 6 hours and 23 minutes, the longest postseason game in Major League history. The Giants have stolen another in D.C.
Game 3 was an opportunity to sweep the Nats in AT&T Park, and it looked to be yet another pitcher's duel. But after a Madison Bumgarner throwing error...
The 1-2. Bunted back to Bumgarner. He's going to go to third and throws it away! Desmond comes in to score. The ball's still free in the bullpen. Harper didn't pick it up till late, but he'll score anyway. 2-0 Nationals!
The floodgates opened, allowing the Nationals to take the lead and the game by a score of 4-1.
Ishikawa with a broken bat roller to short for Ian Desmond, and there will be at least 4 games in this division series.
With the Giants up 2-1 in the series, they were trying to close it out at home and relied on the arm of Ryan Vogelsong to get it done, facing off against Gio Gonzalez for Washington. The Giants jumped out to a 2-0 lead in the second inning due to small ball.
2-2 to Brandon Crawford. Into the opposite field, a base hit. 1-2 pitch, back to Gonzalez. It takes a weird hop, and everybody's safe. And Vogelsong gets the bunt down here. It's a perfect bunt. In fact, so good, everybody's safe. The 3-0. The 0-2 to Panic is bounced to LaRoche. He'll flip it to Gio Gonzalez covering. The run comes in to score. 2-0 Giants.
Vogelsong boasted a no-hitter through 5 innings, but allowed 2 hits, including a Bryce Harper RBI double.
The payoff pitch home, and Harper shoots it into the opposite corner. Desmond to third, where he's being waved around to try to score. He'll do so without a throw, and it's 2-1 San Francisco.
Vogelsong got out of the 5th and got some defensive help to end his day in the 6th, with the score still 2-1.
Worth into the opposite field. Pence back at the wall and makes the catch! Tantamani!
Hunter Strickland came in for the 7th inning, where he would face Bryce Harper, who'd already done this earlier in the series.
Ball is absolutely crushed!
And would do it once again to Strickland to tie the game at 2.
The 3-1. Harper hits it high and deep into the right field corner. If it's fair, it's long gone. That one is fair. Home run! And we are tied! And Bryce Harper's done it to Hunter Strickland again!
And that home run would definitely be the end of the relationship between Harper and Strickland, and they would for sure never see each other again.
Whoa!
History.
And Bryce Harper wants a piece of Hunter Strickland. Here they go! Strickland lands a punch. Harper lands a punch. Bench is empty.
Strickland would get out of the inning with no more damage done. But the game was tied coming out of the 7th inning stretch. The G-men would work the bases loaded and get the go-ahead run on an incredibly impressive predictive broadcasting statement by John Smoltz.
If the timing is not right, it forces that natural two-seamer and almost spikes it down. He's got great movement. He's just got to trust it.
2-1. 3 balls in a strike. It bounces away from
the next pitch, Posey showed his knack for getting thrown out at the plate in this series.
Oh, and that one's airmailed! Here's Posey! Throw to the plate! Is it time to get him?
But that extra run support didn't matter for the Giants, as once again, Romo came in for the hold and Casilla for the save as the Giants won the game 3-2 and advanced to the NLCS to face off against the St. Louis Cardinals.
On the ground to second. Panic to Belt, and the Giants are going back to the National League Championship Series.
In game one, it would be Madison Bumgarner on the mound for the Giants, who got the nod on the hill versus Adam Wainwright. And it didn't take long for the Giants to get a hold of the Cardinals' ace. San Francisco loaded the bases in the second inning, and a Travis Ishikawa bloop single drew first blood.
Bases loaded, one away. And a little flare in the left. That ball might drop. It is down for a hit. One run scores. Pence is going to hold at third. And the Giants lead 1-0 on a single by Travis Ishikawa.
With two down and the bases still juiced, Gregor Blanco hit a hard ground ball that got past the glove of Matt Carpenter to drive in another run.
Blanco. Carpenter kicks it. One run scores. It's 2-0.
The Giants picked up right where they left off in the third and got one to cross the plate off of Brandon Belt sack fly.
Now a 3-2 pitch. Runner goes, fly ball into center, sends Jake back. Tagging is the lead runner. Here comes Buster Posey. No chance. 3-0. Giants on top.
That would prove to be the final run of the game for either team. And the Giants secured game one behind Bumgarner's 7 2/3 innings pitched and only 4 hits given up in a 3-0 victory.
Here's a 1-2. Left side, Sandoval makes the stop, throw perfect, and the Giants take game one. A final of 3-0 behind their ace, Madison Bumgarner.
Game two was a back and forth affair all the way throughout. The Cardinals jumped out to a 2-0 lead.
In the left, a base hit. Everybody moves up 90 feet. It's 2-0.
But then runs in 3 consecutive innings gave the advantage to the Giants.
Right side base hit. One run scores, that's Crawford. Morris will hold at third. And the Giants have their first lead of the night. It's 3-2.
Only for the Cardinals to take the lead once again in the 8th, and then in the 9th, things got interesting. With the Giants down to their last strike, Trevor Rosenthal spiked a pitch, resulting in a wild pitch, and allowing Matt Duffy to score from second.
3-2, skips in, it gets away, here comes Duffy, and this game is tied!
But the Giants couldn't send it to extras, as the leadoff man for the Cardinals in the bottom of the inning hit a walk-off homer to win the game and tie the series.
Long hits it in the right, into the corner, game over. Long wins it in the ninth.
Tim Hudson got the game 3 start, trying to give the Giants the advantage in the series. And he got the run support early. After the first two batters were retired, a 2-out rally saw 5 straight base runners, including an RBI double by Pence.
That's down the right field line. It is fair. Posey will score. Sandoval digging to third. They'll hold him there. 1-0 Giants on top.
And with the bases loaded, a bases clearing double from Travis Ishikawa.
He hammers one into right. Back is Gritchick. At the wall, it is off the wall. All 3 runs are going to score. And it's 4-0 Giants here in the first.
But then the bats went cold for San Francisco, and St. Louis chipped at the Giant lead and eventually tied the game at 4 in the 7th with this home run.
He hammers one down the line. It is gone for the home run, and it's a tie game here in the 7th.
The game would stay that way after 9 and go into extras. And once again, it was small ball that led the way for the Giants with runners on 1st and 2nd.
The bunt. Perfect. Wild throw. And the Giants win game 3.
Now up 2-1 in the series, Ryan Vogelsong would get the game four start against Shelby Miller, and neither pitcher had the start they wanted. The Cardinals jumped out to a 1-0 advantage in the first, but the Giants answered right back after Gregor Blanco got on base with this double.
1-1. That's in the air to center, well hit. Back is Jay. He's dropped it. He was there, lost it. Blanco into second to start the night for the Giants.
And then got driven in by Buster Posey on a sac fly.
In the air to center, Jay back to his left. Tagging, scoring, Blanco. 1-1 game here in the first on a sac fly by Posey.
The back and forth theme would continue after the Cardinals jumped out to a 4-1 lead in the third, but once again in the bottom half of the inning, the Giants would answer back with a two-out single from Buster Posey.
Miller. It's a 4-2 game.
And then another two-out knock by Hunter Pence brought the Giants within one.
Pence gets one up the middle. Here comes Posey. It's a one-run game here in game four. RBI Pence.
Both Vogelsong and Miller were taken out of the game early, and it was the Giants' bullpen once again that had the edge. San Francisco got runners in scoring position in the fourth and fifth, but couldn't capitalize. And finally broke through in the sixth. The Giants went back to small ball after a leadoff walk by Perez.
That misses for ball four.
A single by Crawford.
Hard hit base hit. His first of the series. Stopping at second is Perez, and it's two on, nobody out.
And a sack bump by Duffy.
Only one sacrifice in the big leagues for Duffy. He gets it down. The play to first. One away, and the runners advance to second and third.
Led to runners on second and third with one out for Gregor Blanco, who got an unorthodox RBI.
Right side, Adams will come home, and too late. Tie game.
With the game tied at four and runners on the corners, panic stepped in and hit a sharp grounder to first that Matt Adams tried to turn two. But the throw to second was errant, and Crawford darted in from third.
Adams will tag the bag. Now the run to the plate, and the Giants lead.
After the play, the Giants still had a runner in scoring position with two outs for Buster Posey, and the former MVP capitalized once again.
Here's the 0-2. That's in the left. Posey, another hit. Here comes the runner, no throw. It's 6-4 Giants.
After the inning, the Giants boasted a two-run lead, and the late-inning relief shined once again as Casilla picked up the save in a 6-4 win, setting the Giants up with a 3-1 series lead, just one game away from advancing to the World Series.
Strike three, game over. Giants up 3-1.
Mad Bum got the start for the Giants in Game 5 against Adam Wainwright, but the Giants' ace gave up the first run after Travis Ishikawa misplayed a line drive and left, allowing the Cardinals to strike first.
That's in the air to left. Ishikawa over his head. One run will score. That's Cruz. Carpenter is going to be held at third, and Ishikawa, relatively new to the outfield, misread that ball, and it got behind him.
But the Giants would come right back in the bottom of the inning. After a two-out single from Gregor Blanco, Joe Panik stepped in and hit the first home run for the Giants in 243 plate appearances, dating back to Belt's walk-off in the 18th inning of Game 2 of the NLDS, as the Giants took the lead.
That is hit down the line and right at the wall. It is gone! Two-run home run! And the Giants lead it 2-1 on the first postseason home run by the rookie Joe Panik.
The party wouldn't last for long, as Bumgarner gave up two solo shots in the next half inning to give the Cardinals a 3-2 advantage.
What he did defensively, here's Cruz, replacing Yadier Molina and A.J. Pierzynski, and the Cardinals lead it 3-2 as Tony Cruz, who had one home run all year, has hit a postseason shot to put St. Louis on top.
That's how the score would stand until the eighth, as both pitchers were tremendous down the stretch, combining to retire 22 consecutive batters. But Mike Matheny decided to move away from his starter to try to close out the game with Pat Neshek in the pen. That wouldn't work out too well, as Michael Morse, fresh off his strained oblique, stepped in to pinch hit for Bumgarner.
That's hammered into left! Morse, off the bench! Tie game!
Casilla was called in as the pitcher in the ninth to try to keep the game tied and was helped with a tremendous team defensive effort.
Left side, off the glove of Santiago, and they get the out at second. What a play by Crawford, who hung in there and got the force.
But after loading the bases, Jeremy Affelt was called in to stop the bleeding.
Affelt brings it. Chopper on the infield. Affelt to the bag himself. Gets out of trouble.
Mike Matheny brought in Michael Wacha, the 2013 NLCS MVP, to try to stop the Giants in the ninth, in Wacha's first major league appearance since September 26th. But he immediately gave up a base hit to Pablo Sandoval.
That's into right, a base hit. And the winning run is on. Sandoval, another postseason knock.
And a four-pitch walk to Brandon Belt.
A four-pitch walk.
And then with two on and one out, Travis Ishikawa stepped up to the plate with a chance to send the Giants to the series.
Travis Ishikawa hits one into right! The Giants win the pennant!
The Giants had to wait 5 days before their matchup with the Royals for the World Series, which was enough rest for Bumgarner to be ready to start in Game 1 against James Shields for Kansas City. The Giants wasted no time pouncing on Shields in the first inning, starting with a Pablo Sandoval double.
That's down into the right field corner. It is fair and rattles around. One run score.
And Posey got thrown out at the plate for the third time in the postseason, but the Giants would continue to score runs in the inning thanks to Hunter Pence.
In the air to center, well hit, came back, over his head, and gone! Hunter Pence with a two-run shot and a 3-0 first inning lead in Game 1.
Kansas City would come knocking on the doorstep in the third, but despite second and third with no outs, Bumgarner got the next two batters to strike out and then walked the bases loaded and forced a ground out to end the scare.
Chops one to Penn, and Bumgarner gets out of it. At second and third, nobody out, struck out the next two, and after loading the bases, keeps it 3-0 now after three.
The Giants would step to the plate in the fourth and rock the Royals pitching once again. Michael Morse came to the dish with runners on first and third and shot one right back up the middle for an RBI single.
Holds the bat over the plate, now shoots one into center. An RBI base hit to make it 4-0 San Francisco.
Shields was pulled after giving up four runs, but it didn't matter because the reliever Danny Duffy walked two consecutive batters, including Gregor Blanco with the bases loaded, which walked in a run, making it a 5-0 Giants lead.
Blanco takes low and that'll force on the run. 5-0 on a bases loaded walk.
The seventh inning led to more Giants runs after Joe Panic tripled in a run.
Here's one into right center field. That ball is down for base hit. Gets by Aoki. Panic is going to dig for second. Blanco all the way around on an RBI. it 6-0.
Two batters later, Sandoval drove him in with an RBI single.
That's through the left side for an RBI base hit.
Bumgarner gave up his first and only run of the ball game off a solo homer to Salvador Perez in the seventh. Bumgarner was magnificent all day, only allowing three hits and one walk in seven innings of work. Neither team would score again, and the Giants would end up taking Game 1 with a 7-1 victory.
That ends the night, and the Giants take Game 1, a final of 7-1.
Jake Peavy got the Game 2 start against Jordano Ventura, and Ventura didn't start out hot, immediately giving up a leadoff homer to Gregor Blanco.
That's hammered into right. You want to silence a crowd? Do that. Home run, Gregor Blanco.
But the Royals wouldn't let the Giants hold the lead for long after Billy Butler drove in the tying run in the first.
Hard hit. Base hit. Here comes Kane. Ishikawa's throw.
And the next inning, the Royals took the lead off an Alcides Escobar RBI double.
102 out. Escobar has put the Royals on top. Their first lead of this World Series. 2-1.
The Giants wouldn't let the Royals hold the advantage for long either, as in the fourth inning, Brandon Belt knocked in a run with an RBI double of his own.
He's the tying run at second. And it's a 2-2 game.
Everything fell apart for the Giants in the sixth after Peavy got pulled. The Giants used four pitchers in the inning, the last of which was Hunter Strickland, who gave up four of the five runs scored in the inning.
That's hammered in the left. Off the bat of Infante. It's gone.
The Royals shut down the Giants the rest of the way and ended up winning by that 7-2 score to even up the series at one game apiece.
Royals take Game 2. 7-2. And even this series at a game apiece.
Tim Hudson got the start against Jeremy Guthrie in Game 3. Hudson, making his first ever World Series start at the age of 39, gave up an early run, allowing the Royals to scratch one across in the first.
Here comes a 3-2 pitch. That's to the shortstop. Crawford will go to first, and the Royals take a Game 3 lead.
But after that, both starting pitchers settled in, not allowing runs until the sixth inning, where Hudson gave up an RBI double to Alex Gordon.
That's in the air to center. Back is Blanco on the run. Blanco stays in play. Escobar will come all the way around and score on an RBI double by Alex Gordon. It's 2-0.
Hudson was taken out for Javier Lopez, but the relief didn't help, giving up an RBI single to Eric Hosmer.
11th pitch of the at-bat is shot into center field. Here comes Gordon. There's no throw.
The Giants would answer back in the bottom of the inning after Michael Morse drove in a run with an RBI double.
That is hit. Down the line. Digging for third, Crawford. They'll bring him around. Morse off the bench has the Giants on the board and down by two.
And Posey drove in Morse a few batters later with an RBI ground out. The Giants came into Game 4 desperate for a win, and were riding on the arm of Ryan Vogelsong to get that victory. The Giants pounced on the mistakes of Kansas City starting pitcher Jason Vargas early after a walk, wild pitch, and stolen base, Gregor Blanco found himself on third and was driven in by Hunter Pence. Vogelsong ran into some early trouble in the third inning for the Giants. He just could not find a way to retire the Royals as they singled five times in the inning and scored four runs to take a 4-1 advantage, ending Vogelsong's day.
Here's a 3-1. That's into center field.
The Giants jumped on Vargas for one more run in the bottom of the third, as Posey got a two-out RBI single to drive in Matt Duffy.
Vargas, that's a base hit. Duffy coming around. Buster Posey delivers the hit. The play at the plate, 2-8, 4-2 game.
San Francisco found a way to even it up in the fifth, after a leadoff double forced Vargas out of the game, and the Giants jumped on the Kansas City relief, first with a Pence RBI single. Ned Yost was forced to go deeper into the pen and bring on Danny Duffy, who couldn't stop the Giants from tying the game after letting San Francisco load the bases, allowed yet another run to cross. The next inning, it was a new pitcher on the mound for KC, but the same result for San Francisco, as Sandoval drove in two runs with a single.
That's in the center! Giants lead! Sandoval delivers! One run scores! Here comes another! It's 6-4!
The next batter was Brandon Belt, who wanted to get in on the party and drove in a run of his own. The Giants had a healthy 7-4 lead headed into the seventh, but wanted to add some insurance after the first two runners found their way aboard. Blanco wanted to advance the runners with a bunt, but ended up exceeding his own expectations. Panic got in on the party as well, driving one in the gap, allowing two more Giants to score.
That's into the gap in left center. Dyson will not get there. More scores. All the way around is Blanco. Panic has delivered. Blanco is safe.
The onslaught wasn't over, as Hunter Pence drove a double down the line to drive in yet another run. And if that wasn't enough, Pence would seal the game on the defensive end with a sliding grab.
Six start this postseason, breaking ball, flied into right, Pence is coming on, and he adds a big catch to his night.
The Giants ended up finishing the game with an 11-4 victory and evened up the series before going back to their ace in Game 5.
Led at one point tonight, 4-1, but with that, Game 4.
Bumgarner and James Shields matched up once again in a rematch of Game 1. The Giants got on the board first in the second inning after a Hunter Pence leadoff single. A Brandon Belt bump for a base hit. And a Brandon Crawford sacrifice, which brought in Pence, to give the Giants a 1-0 lead.
To the plate, Pence. Giants lead 1-0. RBI ground out by Brandon Crawford.
Crawford continued his big day in the bottom of the fourth with an RBI base knock, which drove in another run.
Just dumping
center, and Sandoval will score to make it 2-0.
The Giants would continue to hold that 2-0 lead for the majority of the ballgame until the 8th, where they would tack on some more to put the game away for good. Sandoval and Pence opened the inning with 2 singles. And then Juan Perez, the most unlikely power hitter, got a hold of one.
3-2 pitch. Fly ball into center. Back is Cade. This ball bangs off the top of the wall. One run scores. Here comes another. Throw home. Too late. Perez empties the bases, scores 2. And it's 4-0.
But Brandon Crawford didn't want to be overshadowed as the offensive hero of Game 5, so he drove in Perez for his 3rd RBI of the game to give San Francisco a 5-0 lead. But there was no debate over who the real hero of Game 5 was. Madison Bumgarner. He was terrific. Mad Bum went the distance, pitching the first World Series complete game shutout since 2004 in epic fashion, only allowing 4 hits with no walks and 8 strikeouts. Bumgarner's heroic effort allowed the Giants to leave AT&T Park with a 3-2 series lead, only needing 1 win on the road in Kansas City.
Left side, Sandoval.
Game 6 did not go the Giants' way. Jake Peavy struggled mightily on the mound in the penultimate game, giving up 2 runs in the 2nd and being pulled in that inning in favor of Yusmeiro Petit, who did nothing to stop the bleeding, allowing 5 runs in that same inning, compounding for 7 second-inning Kansas City runs. And the Giants never recovered. Yordano Ventura pitched 7 scoreless innings as the Giants were shut out 10-0 in an abysmal effort.
16 years to start a Game 7 of the World Series, and it's official. Game 7 tomorrow night, Royals win Game 6 10-0.
This led to the grudge match, Game 7, for all the marbles. Win or go home, do or die, World Series or bust. Tim Hudson was on the rubber for the Giants against Jeremy Guthrie for the Royals. Both offenses sputtered in the first inning, but found their stride in the 2nd. First, it was the Giants. Pablo Sandoval got pegged to open the inning.
Double up inside on Sandoval. A little cut to this fastball, and excuse me, gets a little bit of the elbow.
Then Hunter Pence singled aboard.
And even he laughs at it. Left side, base hit. And it's 2-on with nobody out here in the 2nd inning for the Giants. Another base hit for Hunter Pence.
And Brandon Belt followed suit with a single of his own to load the bases.
Hard hit, base hit, right side. Sandoval will hold at 3rd. The bases are loaded on a base hit by Brandon Belt.
Michael Morse was up next and did his job driving in a run with a sacrifice fly.
Morse. Into right field. Aoki will make the catch. Tagging and scoring Sandoval. Tagging going to 3rd is Hunter Pence. And the Giants lead 1-0 here in the 2nd.
Brandon Crawford did the same with a sac fly of his own to give his team a 2-0 advantage.
Bullpen springs to action for Kansas City. Here's a 2-0. Fly ball into center. That will be deep enough to score Hunter Pence. Sack fly by Crawford. It's 2-0 Giants here in the 2nd.
The Royals weren't going to let the Giants stay ahead for long, as in the bottom of the inning, Billy Butler singled to start the inning and was driven in by an Alex Gordon gapper.
He hits one into right center. He's done just that. In a roll to the track, all the way to the wall. Here comes Butler. The relay by Crawford.
Then the very next pitch, Hudson lost control of one and hit Salvador Perez.
Now Salvador Perez, runner at second, nobody out, gets smoked.
And then two batters later, Gordon was driven in with a sacrifice fly.
Infante. In the air to center. Blanco, the catch, the throw. Here comes Gordon. Tucked in.
After giving up another hit, Hudson, clearly struggling with command early, was taken out in favor of Jeremy Affelt.
Jabber off the plate. Tough play.
San Francisco quickly found themselves back on defense after being retired in order in the top of the third, and it was defense that shined after Affelt gave up a leadoff single.
Here's one up the middle. Panic, what a play! Gets walked and safe at first. Unbelievable diving play by Joe Panic to take a hit away.
Well, I think what happened here with Hosmer is he slowed down. He's out.
The next half inning, Omar Infante tried to make a web gem of his own, but it was a beat too late as Sandoval reached on an infield single.
That's up the middle. Infante with a bare hand. Cannot get it.
Then Hunter Pence found his way aboard with a single back up the middle.
Here's a 1-1. That's in the air to center. This ball is down for another hit.
And Michael Morse drove in Sandoval with the single to give the Giants a 3-2 lead.
Broken bat, base hit into right. One run scores. Pence will go to third. The throw cut off, and it's 3-2 Giants in the fourth.
Jeremy Affelt would work through the fourth for San Francisco with some tremendous help once again from his defense as Panic flipped yet another double play.
Lincecum again. Here's Perez. Double play ball. Panic. The flip. They got them both. Second consecutive inning. The Giants' middle infielders have turned to double play.
But then, in the fifth inning, Bruce Bochy made one of the gutsiest moves in World Series history. He went to his bullpen and brought in the left-hander, Madison Bumgarner. Fresh off a complete game shutout in Game 5 just 3 days prior, with the ball in his hand and an expectation that he would close out the final five innings. A momentous feat if Mad Bum could pull it off. After giving up a leadoff hit, Bumgarner was perfect, and he needed to be, because the offense was shut down by the Royals' bullpen as well. Bumgarner got through the rest of the fifth.
Kane strikes out, and Bumgarner adds another scoreless inning.
And then retired the side in the sixth.
In the air to center, Blanco is there to his right. Another scoreless inning put up by Madison Bumgarner.
And again in the seventh.
Pitch number 36 is strike three.
And once again in the eighth, only having thrown 52 pitches through four innings.
Popped him up, got it in on the hands, Panic. Ends the eighth.
And then came the bottom of the ninth. The score still 3-2, Bumgarner still on the mound, and the World Series just 3 outs away. Mad Bum got the leadoff hitter Eric Hosmer to strike out.
One away.
And then Billy Butler to pop out in foul territory.
Popped up right side. Will it stay in play? It does. 2 out.
This put the Giants just 1 out away. One man standing between the Giants and immortality. That man was Alex Gordon. Bumgarner had been perfect for 4 2/3 innings, but then everything collapsed.
Here's the 0-1. That's in the air to left center. That ball is down, and it gets passed to the wall. Gordon is going to dig for third. A mistake in the outfield, and he will hold there with 2 out, representing the tying run.
Some thought that Gordon could have scored on the play. It would have been close at the plate, but alas, he didn't go and stayed at third, leaving the games in the hands of Salvador Perez. With 2 outs and a runner on third, a hit extends the game, and an out is a Giants World Championship. The count was worked to 2-2, and then it happened.
Salvador Perez, the 2-2. Giants for the third time in the last 5 years, and their hero, Madison Bumgarner.
Madison Bumgarner won World Series MVP for obvious reason, and the Giants closed out the season with their third championship in 5 years. The ultimate teen team accomplished the ultimate team feat as a huge underdog. They played small, scratched across runs, and were led by stellar pitching and ultimate passion.